Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Terima kasih telah mengklik link video ini. Semoga kita semua dalam keadaan sehat walafiat dan dilancarkan segala urusannya. Sebelum nonton video ini, silakan subscribe dulu ya.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Kebetulan ini hari Jumat, Jumat Mubarak. Insya Allah kita mau pergi sholat Jumat di salah satu masjid yang lumayan aktif dan terbesar di Manchester, Masjid Al Furqon. Yuk, ikutin aja.
Si Masjid Al Furqon ada di kota Manchester, itu ada di area yang namanya Rasum. Ini teman-teman bisa lihat Rasum itu ada di selatan kota Manchester. Nah, ini dia kalau lihat pusat kotanya, ini ada di daerah selatannya. Gitu. Nah, gimana sih directionnya, kita lihat yuk. Kalau dari arah rumah saya, directionnya itu hanya perlu jalan kaki sekitar 15 menit. Kalau naik sepeda itu hanya sekitar 4 menit. Nah, bagaimana kalau teman-teman adalah orang-orang yang sedang berkunjung ke Manchester dari arah pusat kota? Nah, kita bisa lihat ya. Kalau dari Piccadilly Garden itu kalau naik taksi atau naik mobil itu sekitar 13 menit. Kalau naik mobil umum itu ada bus namanya 111. Sorry, ini kita setting karena ininya malam. Kalau di setting siang, ini ada bus namanya 111. Nah, teman-teman bisa naik 111. Itu jarak tempuhnya sekitar 24 menit dari pusat kota. Nah, itu turunnya tidak jauh dari Masjid Al Furqon. Nah, itu kira-kira seputar lokasi Masjid Al Furqon. Sekiranya nanti ada teman-teman yang sedang berkunjung ke Manchester, pengen sholat dan menjadikan Al Furqon sebagai salah satu alternatifnya, jadi tahu lokasinya. Oke.
Alhamdulillah kita udah sampai di Masjid Al Furqon. Kalau dilihat dari arsitektur bangunannya, ini tidak seperti membentuk masjid karena memang ada history dari buildingnya. Nanti kita ceritain lebih lengkap ya. Yuk kita masuk langsung.
How are you?
This bisa kita lihat.
Halo brother.
Assalamualaikum. Tapi insya Allah di sini aman, Pak, sepertinya. Karena ada CCTV. Yeah. Jadi everything will be safe insya Allah. Yuk kita masuk.
Ini kita masuk ke area basement, ke area tempat wudhu. Wudhu pria sama toilet. Ini baru di refurbish tahun 2017. Di depan ada wastafel. Sebenarnya toilet ini bisa diakses langsung dari pintu luar. Ini dari sini. Tapi lebih nyaman kalau kita masuk dari dalam. Jadi nggak perlu sepatu. Ini fasilitas tempat wudhunya. Airnya hangat insya Allah. Jadi meskipun musim dingin gini, nggak ada masalah untuk ngambil wudhu. Kita wudhu dulu ya. Ini toilet. Imamnya sudah datang.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Was sinful fi talab al-ithm. Another category of people, all they chase after is sin. They just wake up and say, how am I going to commit zina tonight? I need somebody to sleep with tonight. Whenever they wake up, I want to commit a certain haram. I want to do gambling. I want to sell drugs. So they're just sinful. Always they're running after sin. Subhanallah. They just, who am I going to kill today? So I can stay in my position and power. Who am I going to get rid of? Who am I going to do this to? This is the other group of people. Was sinful fi talab al-tariq. The third group, they are after the path, the straight path. And look after that what he said. Rahimahullah ta'ala. He said, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَصْبَحَ فِي طَلَبِ الْمَالِ فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَأْكُلُ فَوْقَ مَا رَزَقَهُ اللَّهُ. He said, the one who woke up in the morning running after money, he will never get more than what Allah has written for him. Regardless of how much effort you put in, you're not going to get a penny extra than what Allah has written for you. The second group, he said, وَمَنْ أَصْبَحَ فِي طَلَبِ الْإِثْمِ. The person who's after sin, the person who's after haram things, he just wants to commit sins. That person, when he wakes up, how is he going to end up? لَحِقَهُ الْهَوَانُ وَالْإِثْمِ. That person, he's just going to be humiliated, he's going to just commit sins, and he would be someone who's in trouble all the time. Because they commit sins. وَمَنْ أَصْبَحَ فِي طَلَبِ الطَّرِيقِ سُبْحَانَ. As for the one who woke up looking for the path to reach Allah. That's his destination. He knows his purpose of creation. He wants to get to Allah. What about that person? أَتَاهُ اللَّهُ الرِّزْقَ وَالطَّرِيقِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless that person with what? With the wealth and the path that he was seeking for.
أحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره.
ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة أعاذنا الله منها يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما اللهم اجعلنا من الفائزين في الدنيا والآخرة أيها المسلمون اتقوا الله تعالى وأطيعوه my dear brothers and sisters in Islam and today our khutbah إن شاء الله تعالى is going to be a continuation of the topic that we talked about last week, which was a very important topic. It was regarding al-ghafla, heedlessness. And inshallah ta'ala, before I begin the topic, I also just want to remind myself and all of you how blessed we are. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us with the day of Friday. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the opportunity to come all together in the masjid and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to sit there and be reminded of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Umar ibn Khattab radiyallahu anhu kana yaqul inna ar-rajul la yakhruju min manzilihi wa alayhi min ad-dhunubi mithla jibal tihama. Umar radiyallahu anhu used to say a man would leave his house and on top of him are like in terms of sins are like the mountains of Tihama. These are big mountains in al-Hijaz. And he used to say, "بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ فَإِذَا سَمِعَ الْعِلْمُ." After he hears the knowledge, خَافْ وَرَجَعَ وَتَابْ. So when the person hears the knowledge of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, and he listens to the ayat and the Quran and the hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and the hikam and the wisdom from the our predecessors, what happens? خَافْ. الحمد لله على إحسانه وشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. We just mentioned one sabab, one cause of ghafla. The second one, I just have to go over it very quickly. الجهل بالله, not knowing Allah. والله, the less we know Allah, the weaker our iman is going to be. The more we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the level and the degree of our knowledge when it comes to Allah, that is how we will be as good Muslims. That will depend on how good Muslim you become. So al-jahl billah, that's another cause. Al-ma'asi, when we commit sins, we fall into ghafla. The more sins we commit, the more we fall into heedlessness. So they work together. So you have to remember that. Also, suhbatu su', having bad friends. The more bad friends you have that influence you to do bad things, the more you're going to be falling into heedlessness. Also, brothers, طول الأمل, having wishful thinking. You don't want to change at all, but you want things to change. You need to change yourself. Start by changing yourself. So it's very, very important. And inshallah ta'ala, I am going to finish, inshallah ta'ala, our khutbah today with an ilaj. What is the remedy? How can we remedy this problem? What is the remedy? Number one, inshallah ta'ala, is the following. Al-ilmu billah. Know Allah. How do you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How can you come to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? By studying the Quran. Ikhwani, I repeated this many times. The more we study the Quran, the more we come to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Quran only talks about three things. Like Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala said, "Man huwa Allah? وَمَاذَا يُرِيدُ مِنْكَ وَكَيْفَ يُرِيدُهَا مِنْكَ." That's it. The Quran talks about only three things. Who Allah is, what does He want from you, how He wants it from you. That's it. The Quran only talks about those three issues. Very, very important. Number two, ikhwani, Zikrullah, remembrance of Allah. That's another ilaj. That's another way of getting back to inshallah ta'ala from that illness. Majalisu dhikr, going to the gatherings of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qira'atul Qur'an, reciting the Qur'an. That's ilaj as well. Each and every one of us right now, ask yourself deep down, how many of these things that the imam is saying, the khatib is saying right now, how many of them do I do? Do I need to change some of the things I do right now to become better than, to become better from the ghafla that I am in? You need to ask yourself, ad-du'a wa tadarru' ila Allah. You need to make du'a to Allah to help you achieve that. At-tawbah, very important. Tawbah, like Umar ibn Khattab said, when someone comes to the masjid, for example, or to the remembrance of Allah, he will come and he will have on top of him mountains of sin. But when he hears these words, the ilm, the knowledge when he hears, he is going to have fear in his heart. He's going to make tawbah. And then he'll go back home. Any one of us who wants to go back to his house this afternoon after this Jummah prayer and Asr prayer, with no sins, inshallah ta'ala, all you have to do is make tawbah. Sincere tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from all the sins you have been doing. Okay? And that's it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will wipe them away. SubhanAllah. Look how beautiful our religion is. This is the beauty of coming to Friday prayer, to coming to the gatherings of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى اللهم إن أردت بالناس فتنة فاقبضنا إليك غير خزايا ولا مفتونين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم استرنا ولا تفضحنا اللهم استرنا ولا تفضحنا وأكرمنا ولا تهنا وكلنا ولا تكن علينا اللهم لا تدع لأحد منا في هذا المقام الكريم ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا عاصيا إلا هديته ولا عاصيا إلا هديته ولا طائعا إلا سددته ولا حاجة هي لك رضا ولنا فيها صلاح إلا قضيتها يا رب العالمين إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وأقم الصلاة.
We can inshallah exercise on this weather. It's going to be on Sunday, Falafel Park, Dome Sport. Will be 50 plus, from 12 till 14. So inshallah, anybody, the youth, inshallah, they will need to come and benefit. With by chapter, the name of Allah, what are the great? Ma'anita, ahad, ahdi, ilahi, umar. Ma'anita, ahad, ahdi, ilahi, umar. Ma'anita, ahad, ahdi, ilahi, umar.
Alhamdulillah, kita telah selesai sholat Jumat dan dilanjut sholat Asar karena di winter waktunya berdekatan. Jadi sekalian, sekarang waktunya kita pulang. Terima kasih telah menonton. Silakan klik video selanjutnya ya. Dan jangan lupa subscribe channel kita. Wassalamualaikum. Dadah.